The DKIST telescope stares at the sun. The sun provides a lot of heat. When the sunlight hits our optical surfaces, we need to cool them down to keep them at the ambient temperature to reduce the distortion of the image. That works fine for the primary mirror, and we can do that without a problem. But when we focus the beam onto the secondary mirror, we go from 4 meters down to a beam size of about, I don't know, a foot or so. We can't absorb that amount of heat in our optical surface and not distort it or disturb the image. And so what we do is we introduce a thing called the heat stop at the prime focus. And the heat stop effectively allows us to absorb and subtract the majority of the heat that we have acquired from the primary mirror, from the reflected sunlight from the primary mirror. We supply it, we joke in the project about the fire hoses that we use to actually supply the coolant for it, but we have effectively a couple of 2 or 3 inch diameter hoses that run up to the heat stop and are continually flushing water through it just to take away that heat. The heat stop in normal operation with the full flow of coolant takes away that heat so that we can then use normal cooling methods for the rest of our optics through the train. If, however, we lose coolant to our heat stop, it's a problem, a major problem. And so we have a number of safety aspects that are tied into the heat stop. One is a safety cover that is adjacent to the heat stop in front of it, and in the loss of cooling we close that and it disperses the light, it reflects the light away, but it can only sustain a number of minutes before it also will disintegrate. And so we have a fast-acting mirror cover for the primary, and we also have an aperture cover on the enclosure, which are both fast-acting for their sizes.